that deserves all praise and honor and glory and power forever and ever. Amen.
Darkness. Thank you. Thank you. think sometimes we face huge battles. And I just get a picture, I don't know, it's just like we've had that rain yesterday and everything was depressed and the thick cloud that was on us. And sometimes we feel like that in life, that the clouds are coming right down, nearly pushing us into the ground. But we need to realize that above those clouds, there is clear skies. And as we see that in that song there, that Jesus never stops working. We see it from the bottom, but Jesus sees it from the top. Doesn't matter what battles we're facing, He is always working for us. Always.
Darkness tremble. I know Busy Team's not finished. I wasn't going to preach a message tonight, but God just gave me this scripture and I want to share it and nervously tell you what I think God wants to share with us tonight. I'm a planner, so this freaks me out a little bit. In Mark 8, verse 22, it says, when they arrived at Bethsaida, some people brought a blind man to Jesus and they begged him to touch the man to heal him. Jesus took the blind man by the hand and led him out of the village. I want you to focus on those words, out of the village. Then, spitting on the man's eyes, he laid his hands on him and asked, "Can you see anything now?" The man looked around. "Yes," he said, "I see people, but I can't see them very clearly. They look like trees walking around." And Jesus placed his hands on the man's eyes again, and his eyes were opened. His sight completely restored, and he could see everything clearly. Jesus sent him away saying, "Don't go back into the village on your way home." Now, as I was sitting down the back there and just asking God, what do you want to share out of this passage? There's a couple of things. Sometimes it takes more than once to be completely healed, transformed, or to get the breakthrough that you need. Notice Jesus, Savior, Miracle Maker, prayed for this guy twice before he received complete healing. But so maybe you have come to nights before where, you know, people have offered you a chance to be prayed for breakthrough or for healing or for this or that or something else. Can I encourage you that just keep pursuing those things until you have complete healing or transformation or breakthrough or whatever it is. But the words that I want us to think about today, and I don't know what they'll mean for you exactly, but Jesus took the blind man by the hand and led him out of the village. Notice that blind man had multiple voices around him. Some people brought the blind man to Jesus and they begged him to touch the man and heal the man. I wonder if there was voices in that village that were just maybe moving that blind guy away from where he needed to be with God, right? You know, sometimes we have all these different voices just talking in our head, but we don't need anyone other than God to just speak in and with us, right? Because then Jesus does this healing, and then he says, "Don't go back into the village on your way home." So maybe that means that there's things or voices or stuff, whatever, I don't know what the village might be for some of us, but maybe God's saying, don't go back there. Maybe it was that this blind man relied on his blindness to survive because he begged in the village. It could have been it. And Jesus was saying, well, no more you're going to rely on the things that you used to do, but now you've had an encounter with me, you're going to rely on me. So I just want you to think about that as we continue to worship and sing another song. Don't get back into the village on your way home. And I just ask that instead of having 1,000 different voices that might be speaking to you, just spend some time with Jesus right now. Out of the village, whatever that village. Maybe the village is just distraction for you, the things that you're fretting about. Maybe it is the things that you rely on for your everyday needs. Maybe just put those things away. Don't go back there in your mind right now and just spend a bit of time with Jesus. And maybe there's something that he's started to work on in your life that needs completing right now. Maybe you can just have a moment with Jesus in that. Let's stand and just sing again and spend a little bit of time in his presence.
Oh,
pray it and close our service, but I just want to go back to those words that I just can't shake from my spirit, and I guess it's for someone or some people. Jesus sent him away, him or her, saying, don't go back to the village on your way home. I don't know what the village is for you, but there's some change. Someone knows what I'm talking about, or many people might know, and I just pray that God would do something and speak something into that for you. If you need prayer for something in particular tonight, I'd love to pray with you. Don't feel you need to, you can just pray to yourself, but if you just feel like the laying of the hands and praying, I'd love to pray with you. If you don't yet know Jesus, you don't know what relationship with him is like, I'd love to pray with you over that tonight. If you want to accept Jesus as your Lord and Savior, I'd love the opportunity to pray with you a prayer and make him your Lord and Savior. So if you want to do those things, you're more than welcome, come and see me. Please stay and have a cup of tea and coffee tonight, and say hello to someone and encourage someone. God bless you.
Can I just read something? I have a little book that I read each morning, and it's called I Hear His Whisper. I don't know if anybody else has got it, I love it. And the reading for this morning was, fix your eyes on me. Why are you impressed with all these battles raging against your soul, as if I'm not with you in the midst of them? Though you are a battle weary, I will be your strength. I have all the grace you need to stand, to breathe again, to see things from my perspective and align your thoughts and words with mine. You're distracted, my child, and it's time to completely release your impossible situation into my capable hands. I remind you over and over, I am the God of the impossibility. Nothing is too hard for me. Lean into my arms. Let me be your strength when you have none. Let me breathe into every cell and every thought. Invite me to illuminate every lie with my unshakable truth. Choose to be impressed with my omnipotence. More than your problem, bring me your analyzing and overthinking as an offering of total abandon and trust. Fix your eyes on me, and you will feel me washing away the debris of doubt and frustration. Sing your highest praise and choose to believe despite what you see. Just fitting, I think.